Good morning.
Milord. Milord.
We certainly do the Jews no injustice when we say that the revelation of Christ is simply something incomprehensible and hateful to them. Although he apparently sprang from their midst, he embodies nevertheless the negation of their whole nature, a matter in which the Jews are far more sensitive than we are. This clear demonstration of the deep cleft that separates us Europeans from the Jew is by no means given in order to let religious prejudice with its dangerous bias settle the matter, but because I think that the perception of two so fundamentally different natures reveals a real gulf.
Stevens.
Yes, Father.
We have some refugee girls on the staff at the moment, I believe.
We do, my lord. Two housemaids, Elsa and Herma.
You'll have to let them go, I'm afraid.
Let them go, my lord.
It's regrettable, Stevens, but we have no choice. You've got to see the whole thing in context. I have the well-being of my guests to consider.
My lord, may I say, they work extremely well. They're intelligent, polite, and very clean.
I'm sorry, Stevens, but I've looked into this matter very carefully. There are larger issues at stake. I'm sorry, but there it is. They're Jews.
Yes, my lord.
I'm amazed that you can stand there as if you were just discussing orders for the larder. I simply can't believe it. You're saying that Elsa and Irma are to be dismissed because they're Jewish.
His lordship has made his decision. There is nothing for you and I to discuss.
You realize that if those girls have no work, they could be sent back to Germany.
It is out of our hands.
I'm telling you, Mr. Stevens, if you dismiss my girls tomorrow, it will be wrong. A sin, as any sin ever was one.
Miss Kenton, there are many things you and I don't understand in this world of today, whereas his lordship understands fully and has studied the larger issues at stake concerning, say, the nature of Jewry.
Mr. Stevens, I warn you. If those girls go, I shall leave this house.
Oh, Miss Kenton.